The Beretta Model 1951, let's check it out. Beretta had been using the Model 1934 for a number of years for their military. This was a 380 caliber, very small pistol. And they decided to go with 9mm. They designed the Beretta M1951 as their first breech lock action. And they got the inspiration from the Walther P38, which has pretty much the same design. The Model 1951 was never adopted by the Italian Army, but was adopted by the Italian Navy and a lot of other national police units. And we can see the family resemblance to the later Model 92. And I want to thank Ben over at Classic Firearms for sending the Model 1951 for this review.
Now this particular sample is Parkerized, so that probably notes that it was in the Navy and also that, you know, it's probably reconditioned. But from what I understand, the blued models that are coming in are in really good condition. We're going to go ahead and drop the magazine. You'll notice the magazine release is down here at the bottom of the grip. Pull it out, and the magazine also is Parkerized. This has a little lip, which is typical for these Berettas. And then we're going to check the chamber. Of course, the gun is unloaded. And it's got that open slide design, which is typical for the Beretta models, especially after 1951. And then the magazine fed really well in the gun. We took it to the range and shot quite a bit of rounds through it, and it just functioned just flawlessly. I did give it a little bit of lube before I took it out, just because these have been stored away for a while. Now, one of the unique things about this handgun is its cross bolt safety, which is right here. So with the hammer in the rear position, you can only actuate the safety with that. So you take and push it toward the left, that locks it into place. Then when you fire, just hit it, and then you can go. It's a little different than your lever. Not quite as fast, but it is what it is. It's got the black plastic type grips that are wraparound. Now, in a lot of these, the grips do get cracked. In fact, I have a Hell one. I'll have it right here, and we're going to look at it in a minute. But you can see where the grip is cracked here. I just picked this up at a gun show. These run probably, you know, $200. And while they were licensed copies of Beretta, the quality is not quite there. But this is a nice blued version. And the civilian versions, though, of the Helwan, made in Egypt, you know, it's not quite up to par. In fact, I think there were some heat treating issues with those. But if you do have the Arabic markings on here, it does denote that it is a military firearm. And we've had good success with this one. But I've always wanted, once I did the review on this, to get the actual Beretta. And I'll tell you, it's just a really nice firearm. Now, it's more difficult to compare these two because this is Parkerized. So it has kind of a utilitarian look to it. But I really like that. The serrations are easy to bring back. They're very fine. And then you have your slide release or slide stop right here. And it just has kind of a unique lever to it. And it does release the slide. Now, this is a single action pistol. And that means that when you pull the trigger, there's no action to the hammer. And so when you get that first round, you go ahead and bring the slide back, insert around, and then the hammer's in the rear position. And then you can go ahead and fire the pistol. And of course, after that, subsequent shots will come all the way back as well. And then of course, usually with single action, the trigger pull is pretty simple. And we'll look at that in just a minute. Got a smooth front strap. And then with the grip though, it gives you a lot of gripping surface to it with the ribs here. And so really at the range, you feel like you've got a pretty decent grip to it. And then with this little finger groove, you know, it kind of gives you a full size, and it is, it's a full size handgun. Compared to the original 92, the big thing is it's just a lot thinner. I mean, it's like a single stack version of your Model 92, but course, the Model 92 is a double action pistol. Now, this one is the 92S. This is before they moved the magazine release up here next to the trigger guard. And so, release that, 15 rounds, check to make sure the gun is unloaded. But this is a super smooth action, which Berettas typically have. And to be honest, much smoother than the Model 1951. Now, these were actually in service with the Navy until 1977, when they adopted the Model 92. And so these have been around for a long time and served a long time in the Italian Navy and again with police units all over Italy. Sights are low profile, and here at the back you can see the blade. It is dovetailed in, but the front sight is milled into the slide, so there's no adjustment. The original Helwans actually had adjustable sights, and they were fairly large. It was something that the Egyptians wanted, and then after they started having trouble pulling their guns out of their holsters, they went back to the original Beretta, really low-profile sights. In fact, this Helwan is pretty much an identical to the Beretta, but these were again made in Egypt, and for the military contract pistols, they were in pretty good shape. They fired very well. Iraq also used these. They called it the Tariq. So a lot of people that had served over in Iraq have seen a lot of the Tariqs because they're still being used in Iraq. And now here I have a Beretta Model 70, and this is a single action 380, but it's a lot of similar designs, but because it's a little bit later, it does have the safety up here in the traditional area. But it does retain the magazine release down at the bottom. And again, the signature lip on the Beretta. We're going to pull the hammer back and check the trigger action. A little bit of take up right here. Nice break, and then it stops right after you pull the trigger. Then reset right there. We'll check our trigger pull weight with our Lyman trigger gauge from Brownells. 7 pounds, 10 ounces. 7 pounds, 9.1 ounces. 7 pounds, 4.6 ounces. A little heavier than your typical trigger, but for military firearms, a lot of times they like it to be just a little heavy for safety reasons. All right, I want to thank Fiocchi for sponsoring the 9mm. We're shooting 115 grain full metal jacket, all made right here in the USA.
Shooting the Model 1951 is very reminiscent of the Model 92, except that it's definitely a single stack, so it's really thin, and it's single action. But after that first shot, you really don't know the difference. Of course, all the design is the same. It has that smooth action that the 92 has with that open slide design. It's just a very smooth, slick shooting firearm. Of course, it's definitely a lot thinner than your 92 at the range, so you can tell pretty quickly that you have something more pointable, seems to be a little more balanced. Even though the Beretta 92 served the U.S. military since 1985 to 2017. So this is a really proven design in itself. Being all steel too, it made it really easy to shoot. The recoil was pretty light. I brought my kids down to the range and we did a lot of shooting with it, and it just was a very pleasurable gun. Of course, with the beaver tail, it keeps that slide bite completely out of the picture. Now, we only had one magazine, so we loaded it, and then we also used the Helwan magazine, and seemed to function just as well. But, you know, it's just a great shooting classic firearm, that single stack, and yet has Beretta quality.
As far as disassembly, we're going to drop our magazine, check to make sure the gun again is unloaded. As we have the slide back, there's a little place here in the slide, and then you have your takedown lever. So you're going to bring that back and then just push your takedown lever forward, and then it just releases it right here, and then you can just pull your slide right off so you don't have to pull the trigger. We have our recoil spring and guide rod. It's all steel. And then we have our barrel. Now the barrel has the lock breech design. It's a delayed lock breech right here. And this again is very similar to what Walther was using for their P38. And, you know, they tried to use these with aluminum frames, but it was just a little too powerful and it started cracking the frame. So they went back to the steel frame, which has seemed to do very well. This is a very proven design. In fact, it's pretty much the same as it is in the Model 92 Berettas today. Then for reassembly, just enter in your slide. You have to make sure that the locking block actually fits down into these little cutouts. Bring our recoil spring and guide rod back in. Return the slide to the frame, bring it back, And then when we get to that little notch, we're going to bring down our takedown lever just like this. And it just rests right under the slide and it keeps it into place.
As far as pros and cons of the pistol, it's all steel frame, so it makes it really smooth shooting. And then with the open slide design of the Beretta, they're typically very smooth at the range. It was reliable, fairly accurate, you know, did spread them out just a little bit, but this one is Parkerized, so it's obviously been reconditioned. I'm sure this handgun saw a lot of use, probably more at the range than anywhere else, but definitely a training pistol. But everything is tight, seems to be in really good shape, definitely in single action, so for that first round, you cock it, kind of a unique cross bolt safety, the magazine release down here. I mean, it's definitely old school. And it's something that's a lot of fun to take to the range, you know. And if you're really collecting different type firearms, especially military surplus, having a Beretta M1951 is definitely one you want to have. And again, I want to thank the guys over at Classic Firearms for sending the model 1951. It's great to have a good source to be able to pick up some of these really unusual, unique firearms. Be strong, be of good courage. God bless America. Long live the Republic.
A lot of these, typically the
somebody tell that guy to stop that.